I don't know. I'm all for saving the Earth, but you really think this concert's gonna make a difference?
10,000 names on a petition can't be ignored. Even those bozos at Verawood will have to listen. Hi.
So how'd you finagle a big star like Collin James into this anyway?
Remember Freddie? Hey. Pickpocket, he was at the ranch around May.
Guy kept pilfering your watch?
Yeah, he's the one. Well, it turns out he's a good friend of one of Collin's technicians. Actually, he's the guy that introduced me to Collin.
Well, it's a good idea. If anybody can pack him in, it's him.
Yeah, then pass those out. The more people, the better. The last thing the ranch needs is a pulp mill next door.
All right, 1,300 hours. Guard should still be at lunch. Let's do it. Come on, come on. All right, remember, in and out. The storage shed only, in silence mode inside the perimeter, all right? X-Squad acknowledge. Able.
Lima.
Yankee.
Tango.
Go. Okay. Everybody ready?
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
Why is it ticking? It's not a time fuse, it's remote controlled.
All the best bombs tick.
Shh. Silence mode. Guys, time is not on our side, all right? Get out of here. I'll wait until you clear and blow it. You shut the rendezvous point. Take a short lunch.
Don't give up on a tough teenage. Give me a call when you need a change. Hey! City kids, come on off that street.
Come on off that street.
Work it out to a different beat. Take a walk outside. Outside, you can slam the door. Never, never give up. It don't come for free.
It don't come for free.
You gotta talk it out. You can lean on me. Come on, cross that line. Get on the range and ride. You got something precious. Something precious.
Like it's gonna happen today, folks. Better get back to your chores.
I'll do it. I just need more time.
Vic, the damn horse has thrown you 6 times in 3 minutes.
His yin is resisting my yang. It's a classic clash of wills, actually.
Well, it's not your will that's going to ache tomorrow.
Oh, ye of little faith. Chuckles, Vic. We shall ride as one.
My money's on Chuckles.
Wow. We walked through a time warp or something?
Hey, Reed.
Michael. Henry Concord.
Hello, Henry.
Howdy, pard.
This is Fox. Well, I guess we better get you settled in. Hey, Vic, this is Henry. Do you want to show him around?
Hi, I'm Vic.
How?
You're funny. You are. Really, I mean it.
So this is our budding eco-terrorist, huh?
IQ near 180.
Impressive.
He knows. I don't think he's taking this very seriously.
Why do you say that?
Well, despite his IQ, that stunt he pulled off was careless and stupid, which makes him very dangerous.
We better put this somewhere safe.
Oh, no, please. It's my journal. I need it.
Writer, eh? Okay. But we're not responsible if it gets broken.
Hey, if it gets broken, I'll fix it.
Hey, X-Squad. I love these guys. Able, Tango, Yankee.
You want to borrow it?
Yeah, sure, thanks. My favorite's the leader, Able. Smooth. Great under pressure.
Yeah, he's my favorite, too.
Hey, check this out. No, I mean, I'll do what I can, but... Yeah, okay, yeah, okay, Collin. Yeah. I'll see you soon. He wants me to make a speech at this concert.
Well, that sounds like a good idea.
Oh, yeah. Thousands of kids screaming to see Collin James, but first, a few words about the environment from Michael Terry.
You blew up a shed full of oil?
That's right.
With what?
It was a pipe bomb, homemade.
You're bitching.
Yeah, it was quite bitching.
Well, why did you do that?
Well, you see, the company that owns the site has a history of illegally storing toxic waste.
So what, you figured the best way to get people's attention is to set off a bomb?
That's right.
Wait a minute.
Boy.
You don't have to blow things up to get what you want. There are other ways.
Like what? Letters to the editor?
That company has 4 major lawsuits pending.
And all 4 are being clogged up in the courts by the best lawyers in the country. It's been dragging on for over a year now.
Well, it's not going to happen overnight. You have to have patience.
No, you can be patient. You see, we don't have the time. We're exterminating 1 species of plant or animal every day.
Really?
The planet can support complex life for 40 more years, tops. That's if we don't blow ourselves up first. Time for negotiations has passed. It's our future at stake, not yours.
Gas or diesel?
Damn thing runs on my sweat and blood. Give me a horse any day. What do you want?
Well, we're done our chores. The guys are helping me acclimatize.
Yeah.
This will be obsolete soon.
It's obsolete now.
Well, you know, you could convert it to hydrogen fuel. Use solar energy to create the hydrogen, save money, cut down on hydrocarbon emissions. Of course, technology is sophisticated.
Out here, we like to avoid sophistication.
Well, least you could do is convert it to gasohol. Build a biogas generator out back. Use access grain, silage, cow dung. Slight adjustments to the carburetor, you're in business.
Oh, carburetor. I left the new part on the kitchen table.
Tell you what, kid. You get me the specs on that biogas dung thing. I'll run it by our resident bean counter. How's that?
Well, we're at it. You think we could discuss the use of chemicals in this ranch?
He's quite a kid.
Yeah. But in spite of all his smarts, he's just that. A kid.
It's yours?
Yeah. It's kind of a template for my extracurricular life. That's me.
Right.
You know, I'm thinking that a great place for the main fermentation cell would be out in the field beyond the barn.
Yeah, I think that biogas idea is great.
It's not enough. We have to think bigger on a global scale. You know, time's running out for you and me. We just can't sit around and wait.
Biogas. What's that, another name for cow farts?
Well, same principle, actually. Guy's gonna help me build it?
No way. Michael Mace is doing half chores.
Well, you guys really like the idea.
Not that much.
You wanna do it? Go for it. You have our blessing. I'll help you.
Well, thank you.
I don't know, Fox. These environmental schemes are all well and good, but they cost a fortune, and we're not exactly flush right now.
Read close there. It says we could make our money back in fuel savings in no time.
Yeah, but there are insurance considerations, the question of capital expenditure versus depreciation, that sort of thing. Oh. I see that's already covered.
Well, shall I tell them to go ahead? Or do I need a purchase order?
What'd you say, Fox? Yeah! Right on!
Awesome. All right, let's do it.
Let's go.
We're going into town to put up some of our posters. You guys want to come?
I think I'll stay here, Michael, for my biogas generator.
But the Collin James concert's important, too. It is an environmental benefit.
How could slapping litter all over the city be a benefit to the environment?
Well, they're going to get everybody at the concert to sign a petition to stop this company...
Ferrowood?
Yeah, from building a pulp mill near here.
Right, right. Yeah, I know all about that. You know, that would be an ecological disaster to this whole area. Still, I'd rather stay here, work on the biogas project. Mm-hmm. If you still help me, I'd really appreciate it.
Sure. Well, can I?
Do it yourself. You guys want to come, or do you want to stay here and help Henry?
What's the matter?
It's time to start thinking bigger. Come on.
Henry, what are you doing?
Calling my people. The X Squad.
That's it, right there.
A ceramic switch would be less susceptible to fluctuations.
Well, maybe we could ask NASA if they have any extras.
That must be a message from Abel.
Right! Squad's back in business.
What's he saying?
Greetings from the void.
I thought he was at a ranch.
So, you talk to them through the computer like a phone?
Yes, bulletin board. He accesses it with a modem. We talk over it all the time. I'm telling them about this Collin James concert.
Why?
I think it would make an excellent diversion.
Diversion? For what? Henry, what are you gonna do?
We believe in action, Tannis. We've made a commitment to get things done, to do whatever it takes to clean up the Earth. Not enough people care.
I care.
But caring means doing something. You willing to make that commitment?
So you like poetry? You have two sisters and a cat. What else?
I don't know. What else do you want to know?
Well, why were you sent here?
I tried to kill my father.
What? Really?
Tossed a toaster in the hot tub.
Are you serious?
He survived.
Well, you must have had a reason.
The best. Michael's helped me a lot. I don't know what I would have done without him.
Michael? Really?
I mean, it's not like he saved your life or anything.
It's exactly like he saved my life.
How'd it go?
Oh, not bad. We handed out a box of flyers and just about got in a fight.
A fight? Really?
Yeah. We're handing out flyers, right? And Gordy hands one to this guy in a suit.
Big dude with a cigar.
Ultra conservative. And they start talking about the environment and Vera Wood and dumping toxic waste and polluting the rivers and stuff. And this guy's getting madder and madder. And Gordy just saying, "It sucks! It sucks!" This guy is starting to get real choked. And he's just about to drift him, but to sort of calm him down.
Maybe Gordy should have told him that if all the water in the world could be fitted into a 1 gallon jug and the non-drinkable water removed, you'd be left with one draw. Yet we persist in destroying our rivers with industrial runoff and radioactive waste.
Mm. Well, that's better than "it sucks." Yeah. We could have used you there today.
No. No, what you could have used is a more effective course of action. Not some silly concert.
Yeah, like dressing up and blowing up a shed? What if somebody was hurt?
Of all the creatures on the planet, humans are the most expendable. There's 5 billion of the suckers, and they're not on any endangered list.
Michael, there's a work crew out on the access road. I think they're ready to start widening.
Vera Wood?
Yeah. You stay here.
I gotta see this. You ride?
Who's in charge here? You can't start the construction till after the hearing.
I'm sorry, but the memorandum of understanding allows Bearwood to perform certain preliminary road work.
So the logging trucks will be ready to roll in any moment?
If you'd like to lodge a complaint, I'd be happy to give you the number of our PR department.
I'm waiting to speak to somebody in the public relations department, please. Yeah? My name is Michael Terry. I own a brief. No.
No, don't put me on.
Put you on hold again, huh?
Yeah.
What's the song, Girl from Ipanema?
No. Now it's Born Free.
I hate that song.
So, I was talking to this guy, you know, the foreman, just a normal guy, you know, just wants to do his job. And there's Henry, giving me this real smug look.
He was the kid you were telling me about? Yeah. The kid who's into terrorism? Or?
Yeah, he thinks it's more effective.
Ah, the quick fix.
Yeah, I wish I could convince him that violence isn't an alternative. So, what do you think?
What do I think of the speech?
Yeah, be honest.
Honest, huh?
Yeah, I can take it.
It's terrible.
Oh, well, didn't have to be that honest.
Well, you could always get Henry to write it.
You know, that's not a bad idea. That's a great idea. It's a good way to get him involved. Hello? Yes? Yes, yes. Uh-huh. No, I'm waiting to speak to somebody in the public relations department. Yeah, my... No.
Michael's on the phone with Barrowood's PR department.
They'll time up for hours. They're experts at obfuscation.
So what are you doing now?
A little PR work of my own.
You calling the X-Squad again?
I'm getting things done.
Oh, man. This is heavy stuff.
I'll go solo on this one. Are you sure? Piece of cake.
Hey.
X-Squad!
If I finish eating
now.
Would you mind sharing with me what this is all about?
Don't pretend you don't know.
Michael, I had nothing to do with it. I was here all night.
Can I come too?
Sure, why not? Good idea.
I heard they stopped the work up on the road.
For a couple of days, yeah. Now Verawood can claim that they're victims of fanatics. And overnight, people like me get lumped in with people like you, and I don't like it. Get in.
Greenfield, to the burn unit, please.
So you want to tell us what's going on? What are we doing here?
Come here.
Dr. Dvorak, please report to pathology.
Dr. Dvorak, to pathology. Take a look. You know who she is, Henry? Her name is Jamie Lloyd. She's the youngest electrical engineering student in the country. She's a genius, just like you. She was planting a homemade bomb. Police figured there was a burst in static electricity. Bomb went off in her hands. They had to amputate both of them.
She should have known better.
Dennis, if you know something.
I don't. You knew that girl.
What do you want me to say? I'm sorry?
Okay, I'm sorry. But more than that, I am angry. Somebody is going to pay for this, you can be sure.
Who?
Firewood. It's because of them this happened.
What?
They initiated all this. They're the ones who have to answer for it.
I don't believe this. Henry, you gotta stop. You can't keep doing this. She almost got killed.
Yeah, she almost got killed. She knew the risks involved. But she did it anyways because she understands it's not for herself. It's for you and me and Michael and everyone. And I am not going to let her suffering be in vain, all right? I can't.
This is wrong, Henry. What you're doing, it doesn't solve anything.
Why did you try to kill your father?
He did some bad things to one of my sisters.
What kind of bad things? Okay, tell me, when you tried to kill him, did he stop doing these bad things?
Yes.
That is my point exactly.
But I didn't have to try and kill him. All I had to do was tell someone and not take it all on myself. It saved me a lot of trouble.
Did Michael tell you all this?
Henry, I thought we were going to do this together. You and me. Get things done.
So did I.
Just promise me you won't do anything else.
What can I do? I'm stuck out here in the middle of nowhere.
Okay, I promise.
How many friends has he got out there?
I don't know.
Is he planning anything else?
He promised me he'd stop.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Come on, Vic.
Getting there.
You watch. We'll be trotting in a parade when I'm through with them.
Call me.
Who's next?
This horse chuckles. He's not funny anymore. Vic, I need you to help me keep an eye on Henry, especially around the ranch house. We'll have to unplug the phones when we're not using them.
Maybe you should just send him back to detention.
No, can't do that, man. We don't know how many friends he's got out there, who the boss is. He's our only link to them.
So you figure if you can change his attitude, maybe he'll tell his friends to stop doing whatever they're doing?
I gotta keep trying to reach him.
Pretty tough to sway a kid with 180 IQ.
Yeah, it's kind of like trying to ride old Chuckles.
Yeah? I'll tell you what. I won't give up if you don't give up.
You're on.
Hey, Chuckles.
Once more onto the breach!
Hey, Henry. How you doing?
Good.
You hold this?
I wanted to ask you a favor, Henry. Colin asked me to write a speech for it before the concert, and I did, but I was wondering if you could give me some help with it.
You're asking for my help?
Well, everything that you believe in, everything that you want changed, I do, too. I just don't agree with your methods. And this would be a great platform to voice your concerns. I thought I'd offer you the opportunity.
Why not? Couldn't hurt.
Great, thanks. Can I give you a hand with anything?
No, thank you.
In the hospital. It's over.
The X squad never quits. It's Abel. He's got another mission.
I said rev it up, baby. Switch it into overdrive. I don't want to blow no business. I'm trying to stay right by your side. Lady driver. Lady driver at the wheel. I can hear your engine humming. Sounds like a real fine automobile.
Can you play that this afternoon?
Yeah, something like that.
Something.
Yeah. Hey, Collin. I'd like you to meet Henry Concord. Henry, this is who I wanted to meet. Good. How you?
Collin came out to read your speech.
It's powerful stuff.
Well, thank you. It was kind of hurried.
Ah, it'll blow him away. Do you like music?
No. No, I'm into geopolitics, environmental studies. It doesn't matter.
Oh, man, music matters, you know? It's good for the soul.
Good for the soul. I'm a rational atheist. I don't believe in the soul.
Sure you do. I mean, you know, anyone who writes a speech like you did's gotta believe in the soul. Anyway, I should get rolling.
I'll see you all this afternoon.
You betcha.
All right.
Theater. Sure, yeah. You know, that speech is good, Henry.
I don't want to go to the concert.
You sure? I was kind of hoping that you'd read the speech.
Can I be excused from work now?
Yeah, sure.
Slow. I could use your help.
Michael says you're not going to the concert.
I'd rather stay here.
What are you going to do?
Why? So you can tell Michael?
Here, I got you a present.
What's this?
Poetry. Read where I mark.
The force that through the green fuse drives the flower drives my green age. That blasts the roots of trees is my destroyer. What does that mean?
So you don't know everything after all. Michael? I was wondering, do you think I could make that speech today?
Are you sure?
It's kind of important to me. I'd really like to do it.
I think that's a great idea.
I think he's planning something.
I know.
He told me a few days ago that the concert would make an excellent diversion, but he wouldn't say what for. I just don't want to see anybody else get hurt.
Me either.
He'll probably make his move during the concert. As soon as he does, give me a call.
Michael, I'd like to come along as well. Well, don't look so surprised. I don't want to see the mill built either.
Okay. Every signature helps. You can go with Fox.
Does that thing run?
Yeah, it'll get you there. it's all downhill anyway.
Why don't we take my car instead?
Hey, Collin.
Well, hi.
How you doing, man? I'm great.
Good. Well, how's the crowd out there today?
Yeah, they're already lining up to sign the petition.
That's fantastic. Hey, excuse me. Is this where the Barrowwood Company picnic is being held?
Hey, Ben, come on in.
Insane. Abel will have a plan.
Is it a go?
Yeah. Here's the target. It's the hydro plant and access bridge.
Why does he want to hit that?
Of course. That's where Verawood will draw the power from the pulp mill. We hit it, and we set him back months.
Forget it.
No, we can do it. Lima was working on some shape charges for metal structures. It's the perfect time to use them.
You can count me out, okay? Because I can't do it. I've had enough. Where's Tango?
He jammed.
You got the explosives? And the detonator?
It's my dad's garage door opener. I'll need it back.
Okay. Listen, as soon as we plant the bombs, get out fast, all right?
Okay.
Squad acknowledge. Abel.
Yankee.
The organizers of this benefit would like to take this time to thank you all for coming out today. We'd also like to remind you to show your support by signing the petitions against the building of the Verawood pulp mill.
Yeah, Vic?
He tapped into the phone line with his computer in the tack room. Then he made his move.
Where?
I tracked him down to the access road. He's heading straight for the hydro plant.
Is he going to meet anybody?
I don't know. Could can get close enough to read the computer screen.
I'll meet you there.
Hey, Quinn.
Tell Collin I got a split, and Tannis will read the speech.
Speech now.
Little Miss Tannis is gone.
What?
I looked everywhere. She's disappeared.
Well, just keep looking, okay?
Well, who's gonna make the speech then?
I would mind, but my voice, you know?
I'll do it.
Great.
Right.
Great.
Okay.
It's gonna be fine.
All right.
They planted explosives. I think they're gonna try and blow the hydro plant and the access bridge.
How many are there?
Well, I just saw Henry and the girl, but there could be more.
Okay, stay here and call the police.
Yeah, hi.
You do this, Henry. Your life is over, man. How many are there?
Just me. Or maybe I got guys all over the place keeping a very close eye on me.
Henry, listen to me. You don't want to do this.
I know exactly what I want, Michael. I keep telling you that.
Do it, Henry!
Tannis, get off of there!
No! Why you do it? What's one human life anyway?
Henry, thousands of people are hearing your words right now. They're signing the petition. They're going to shut down Barrowwood, and nobody's going to get hurt, and nobody's going to go to jail.
This isn't a comic book, Henry. It's time to grow up.
The fragile miracle of which we are a part of is threatened. Our small green home, the only home we have, needs our help. Stop Fairwood from ruining our valley. Please sign the petitions. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll see what I can do. Unfortunately, the judge didn't think it was such a harmless prank this time.
Well, I spoke to him in detention. I think he's really made a turn. It would be great to get him back out here.
And he still has to finish that biogas generator, so...
Biogas?
Well, yeah, it makes perfect economic sense.
It'd be a shame to ruin this land. You think the petitions will do the job for you, Michael?
Over 10,000 signatures.
Plus 6,000 from the media. And twice that from high schools, and the university students are still sending him postcards.
We raised a lot of voices. I think we gave it a good shot.
You think Henry Concord would agree with that?
I think so.
Hey, check this out. I'm gonna chew gum at the same time. Huh?
Finally.
Finally.